I think what drew me back with this was definitely Francis Lawrence. I mean, we have a history and we've done other projects together. Also, aesthetically, it looks completely different than the other films. We had a lot of conversations about what the overall look should be, how we should portray all these characters, and how would we show the time difference from it being so much further in the past than the last.
We are telling almost a period piece to the previous Hunger Games films, right? So you want some sort of future elements, but you want to feel like it's in the past. You know, I discussed that with Trish, and then Trish was able to sort of go for that look, which was really fun, to create that almost 40s, 50s feel, but with a slight sort of future twinge to it.
I did a lot of research on 1940s and early 50s, looking at what men's suiting was like, what women's dresses were like, and then we exaggerated it a bit, just giving each thing a little bit of a twist so we weren't really tied to a specific time period.
You can tell Trish loves her job so much just because she'll be talking about all the different processes she went through sourcing jewelry or buttons. Every minute detail of every costume she has put so much thought into. It's really inspiring to watch her work.
So the Academy look, I like the idea of having male and female students all in the same thing. And the Capitol is a very regimented society, so you don't really get to pick and choose what you want to wear. This is what's issued to you, and this is how everyone has to look.
I think Trish Somerville was one of the first people I met. We tried on some of the costumes. We tried on the school uniform, the Academy uniform, and they call it Academy Rouge, this bright red color. And it's also very contemporary because she's bringing kilts into it, but then she's also made it kind of boxy and quite authoritarian and utilitarian. And she's kind of meshed these two worlds in this way that feels very unique and original. And then we tried on the uniform for the peacekeepers in District 12, and it reminded me of like a really oppressive force. I remember in that moment thinking, oh, she gets the story.
The rainbow dress. For me, that was probably one of the hardest costumes to design because of the title of the rainbow dress and all it has to do throughout the film.
When you're a costume designer and you're given the task that your protagonist is going to spend a good part of the movie in a rainbow dress with ruffles, you know, there are a lot of ways to go wrong.
There was definitely a few iterations of what I was drawing and coming up with an illustrator. And then figuring out, okay, so if I do the rainbow starting the waist down totally and a gradation of color, it was taking tons of fabrics and doing several versions of what colors work together. And then it was, what fabric could we use to keep it light so that she could run around in it? It had to be some kind of tulle mesh. And then we did under layers and a pot de spree base to sew it all on. I really wanted to pull in a bit of a corset shape I used for Katniss so I can have some tie-ins, and then integrating the snakes and Katniss and primrose flowers just to have another tie-in to the Catching Fire books.
This is a hand-painted vest. There's so much detail that went into it. And then, you know, beyond this dress, there's this 100-year-old vest that I wear on stage at the Hob, and Trish just did such a beautiful job.
People should appreciate actually the monumental task of being a costume designer on a movie like this, and how hard it is to keep both like your inspiration and actually make sure that people have amazing costumes to wear on the first day of shooting.
What are the Hunger Games for?
The Hunger Games are to punish the districts.
For lies!
I'm your mentor.
You seem like a good man, Corlena Snow.
I have seen what war does to people.
Your role is to turn these children into spectacles, not survivors.